Hello students, welcome to the session on Spring Framework Introduction. This is Rupali Pangaram, ISMIC Madurai. Today we'll discuss the Spring Framework. Before that, when the framework word is there, what comes in your mind? Many of you might have worked on the .NET framework. What is that exactly? On .NET framework, you can take one component or drag one component like text box or button, and immediately you will be dragging it and dropping it on your screen. But do you know what exactly happens behind that screen in code part? Have you observed that? Yes, of course. You will be creating the object of that button or the text field, and accordingly that object will be invoking that view part onto the screen. So simply, the framework is nothing but the collection of multiple components, multiple classes, or you may call it as library also. So the similar kind of framework is available in Java also. The name is Spring Framework. Not exactly the similar. You are not having any drag drop facility in Spring. So I only wanted to convey you the message. Framework is nothing but the platform where you will be availed some libraries, some dependencies, some components ready-made available to use. So before going to that Spring Framework, let's revise few things from your advanced Java topics. You might have visited the networking, you might have visited the, or you might have learned about JDBC, you might have learned about your JSP, Servlet, and many more things. So have you observed one thing? Each and every topic has to have some library. Like if you are having JDBC connectivity, you have to take one JDBC library rather than connector file. And if you want to have the JSP code, by default it will be calling the servlet, but if you are having some separate classes, so everywhere you have to connect it. So that should not possible, and that was really the tough task for your software developer when it comes to the bigger application. From that sense, they have developed one framework where everything will be made available for your developer, so that developer will concentrate only on the business logic part. So let's discuss what are the features for your Spring Framework. So let's discuss few Spring Framework features. The first and most important thing is what the Spring is lightweight. This lightweight word you might have heard related to your jQuery also. jQuery is a lightweight library and all. So what is that exactly, lightweight? We discussed at that time, write once, run everywhere and every time. So the same feature is available with Spring also, but more than that, lightweight is also concerned about your size. If you see, the basic version of your Spring is only of 1 MB, and the processing overhead of your Spring is also negligible. In that sense also, you may call this Spring Framework is a lightweight one. Now the next feature is what, your inversion of control. Now inversion of control, before going to that, you should know the dependency. What do you mean by dependency? The student is a class. Let's assume the student is having subject. Am I making sense? Student is having a class. So let it have the simple example. Okay, car. The car needs the important component, engine. Without engine, your car won't work. So it will be like this. The car has engine class, or rather than engine object. So in order to execute this car, you need to have this engine object, and this engine object you need to create in within the method. Can you observe that car won't be running without engine? It means the car is totally depend on your engine. So before creating a car class, you should be in position to have engine class in your hand. So this thing is called as your dependency. Now this dependency you need to create as a developer, you need to create. So again, the developer will be busy in creating such dependencies. First it will create the dependency and then it will create the main logic. So that should not happen. So we have removed that dependency creation or the calling object here. Of course, car will need engine, but that car doesn't have that engine object creation part. So what your Spring Framework does, Spring Framework removes this engine creation from car and it will be asking that thing to the third party, where third party is nothing but your Spring XML, which will provide me the engine object. And now this engine is nothing but my dependency. So this dependency is provided by my framework. Can you relate this thing? Now here, in this example, you have to create the object first and then you need to call the car class. So you have to have the process control or a process flow as object creation first, and then you will be calling the car object. So in the Spring framework, you are inverting your control flow. Matlab, see here, car object requires engine, but you are not creating that engine object and it is being provided by some third party. So this is how you are inverting your control. So this thing is called as your inversion of control, and here the third party will intrude your project by the some dependency injection. So this is what your inversion control. We will discuss this inversion control and dependency injection in detail with the example. Now, aspect oriented. You might have heard the similar word object oriented. What was that exactly? Everything was based on your object. You will be creating object, then you will be abstracting it, then inheriting it, and many more things you will be doing with the object. So main focus was your object, but here the main focus is what your aspect. Now what is this aspect? Like there are few functionality which are common in multiple applications, like security is common, like backup is a main functionality which is common for every application. It doesn't matter which type of application you are having. Even though you are having e-commerce site, even though you are having ERP, still backup is a main functionality which is being required by both the applications. So this is what your aspect. You can say the log record, how many users are logging into my application, how many users are logging out of my application. So log is also the common aspect. So such type of aspects are designed once and we will be using those aspects in multiple applications. So this is how you will be having aspect oriented. We also will also discuss this aspect oriented concept with example, how you will be creating the Spring application and all. Then next one is what your container. Of course, when you are having such multiple things at a time in a simple structure, simple framework, you will need a container. Of course, you will put all these common aspects, you will put all these component dependencies in your container. Then the next one, MVC framework. Of course, if you want to develop your web application, then you need to have your model, view, controller separately. But here you don't need to create everything on your own. It will be handled by your application framework and it will divide your component into multiple phases with the model, view and control. Of course, we'll discuss this also. Then transaction management. Now everything is being provided by your framework and you need to only focus on your transactions, and that is nothing but your business logic. So that was your transaction management. Last but not the least, of course, you may need to handle your database also. So for database handling, the Spring is having its own ORM framework, and that is nothing but your Hibernate. Of course, we'll discuss these topics in detail with these examples. Okay, so that's all for today. In next session, we will discuss about your Spring architecture, Spring framework architecture, and then we'll discuss about the basic Hello World example of your Spring. Okay, thank you for today. We'll have the next session tomorrow. Thank you.